As of August 10th of 2025, there are currently 45 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is the same number as were erupting last week. One of these lesser-known erupting volcanoes is Tonga's Tofua volcano, on which a team of scientists recently discovered a previously unknown active lava lake. This is the sixth such feature currently in the world, and if you want to see more footage of this tropical volcano, check out Extreme Pursuit's footage in the video description, with this lava lake being about the size of a high school basketball court. Tofua is a distinct ring-shaped island with a large caldera that formed in a major eruption during the 11th or 12th centuries. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Chile, the alert level was raised at a sizable, primarily rhyolitic volcano in response to an elevated level of earthquakes and uplift. What I'm referring to is the Laguna del Maule complex. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, a new eruption occurred at the Dempo volcano, sending a plume of ash more than a kilometer above its summit. And in what is this week's top story, Hawaii's Kilauea volcano, after a lengthy wait, produced its 30th episode of cyclical lava fountaining that has been ongoing since late December of last year. Relevant lava fountaining began at 1:20 a.m. local time on August 6 when a series of up to 50-meter or 164-foot-high lava fountains were generated from both its north and south vents. Then, something unusual occurred, something that had not occurred during any of the prior 29 eruptive episodes. Specifically, a third new vent unexpectedly emerged to the south of these two vents, and since it was new, this occurred as a 100-meter-long eruptive fissure. These three vents would each produce fairly sizable volumes of lava that would flow as rivers of molten rock within Kilauea's summit caldera. That third vent will become inactive within 5 hours of its formation. You might note that the lava fountains generated throughout the August 6th episode were far smaller than those of prior episodes. The reason for this is twofold. To me, it appears as the summit vents widened, meaning that now rising molten rock was no longer confined into a constrained space like a rocket engine, and also that July 20th may have marked a slight change in the eruptive cycle. In other words, the next lava fountaining episode may also have smaller lava fountains, probably not surpassing 1,000 feet in height, most likely occurring between August 15th and August 23rd. As for the 30th eruptive episode, throughout its 12.5-hour-long duration, an average of 176.6 cubic meters of lava erupted per second. This reduced the caldera floor's depth by 4 feet. Altogether, Kilauea's 30 episodes have erupted a total of 132 million cubic meters of molten rock. Meanwhile, in Chile, on August 7th, the alert level of the remote Laguna del Maule volcano was raised from green to yellow. Since the beginning of May, the number of daily volcano tectonic earthquakes have increased by 200%, often averaging 300 a day. But, more importantly, alongside this, the rate of ground deformation due to pooling underlying magma has increased from a still one of the highest rates on the planet of 20 centimeters to 50.4 centimeters a year. This might sound quite concerning at first, as Laguna del Maule has more than 100 cubic kilometers of magma in various states when discussing the combination of its magma chamber and magma reservoir. However, do not be too alarmed, as this volcano has undergone frequent uplift cycles, with sections of a lake shoreline it is named after being uplifted by as much as 60 meters or 200 feet in the last 10,000 years. During this time, Laguna del Maule has produced 6 rhyolite eruptions, the last of which occurred about 1,600 years ago. So, in my interpretation, what we are witnessing is merely one of the volcano's temporary increases in unrest and probably won't result in a new rhyolitic volcanic eruption anytime soon. And in Indonesia, the Dempo volcano on the island of Sumatra erupted for its first time in 6 months. The eruption in question was phreatic, occurring on August 7th when a large explosion within its summit crater ejected a plume of ash to an elevation of 1,200 meters or 3,937 feet above its summit crater. More similarly sized eruptions could occur during the next 1 to 2 weeks, or this might just be a one-off eruption. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on August 9th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Fubberpish, for supporting my work.